A lot of questions I've been getting recently is like, Hima, what are you going to be giving up next year in 2022? Like, what is it that you want to change? And I thought, you know what? There's a really good thing that I could do for this. I could share with you guys everything that I want to stop this year in 2022 or next year in 2022. And then that way, if I share this video with you guys, then you can hold me accountable. So, let's go. The first thing that I want to give up in 2022 is snacking. The past 2 years, I've just been getting to a really bad habit of snacking. Like I just felt like I was spending so much time at home that I associated boredom with eating food. And so every single time I got bored, which was quite often, I would end up eating a lot of food. And it would just be something like I was just always eating constantly, not stopping at all. And like the fact, because you know, all the gyms were closed and everything and I couldn't work out, then everything, obviously my whole body just paid the price because of it. And I think in 2022, given that everything's gonna change, I definitely wanna get back to a kind of a physique that I feel like I'm internally really happy with. Like at the moment, I'm like healthy. Like I'm healthy, but I'm not happy with exactly how I look. Like although this might be a little bit of happy weight right here and on this over here, I don't feel like, you know what, this is something that I want to carry on for too much longer. So I'm definitely going to be stopping that snacking. And I know there's research that goes both ways. There's research that suggests, you know, snacking is okay, that snacking is not good. Like there's research that goes both ways. But I think for me personally, like when I think about, you know, what I eat and how I navigate through my day, I don't believe like snacking is something that is really serving my goals in 2022. So that's something I'm definitely going to stop. The second point is overextending myself too far. I remember watching a video in 2021 where there was this guy that basically spoke about how, like, you know, you should in your 20s, like, extend yourself as far as you can, right? To like, and see how much you can do and then pull back to a certain point so that's like at a healthy pace. And I really did that. Like, I really overextended myself, especially in the past 7-8 months. I was doing YouTube, I was working part time at retail, I was I was obviously doing work at the man cave. I was obviously doing all my seminars as well. Obviously, you know, here, there, between lockdowns and everything opening and closing, like I was doing a whole bunch of different things, which was really overextending myself. And I don't think that that is something that is maintainable. I think to certain levels it is, and depending on who you are, your body, your energy and all that, you can maintain different levels. But I don't believe what I did this year, in 2021, especially towards the end of 2021, is sustainable for the long term. I've gotten to a point where, you know what, I overextended and then I pulled back slightly and I'm at a really good healthy pace. And this is something that I want to carry on into 2022 and really maintain that pace along the way. Of course, if I feel like, you know what, I can extend myself a little bit further, I will. But for the most part, I'm going to pull back a little bit this year and really kind of enjoy the journey a little bit more. Another bad habit of mine that I really want to get rid of in 2022 is being extremely critical of myself, like being way too harsh on myself. If I don't get something right or like things don't work out, I completely take ownership and then I completely blame myself for the whole situation. That's either gone, like that's gone extremely bad or that has like a lot of stuff up. And then like I beat myself up for it. And like, it's not a healthy thing to do. But I think it's because I pride myself like, you know, on doing well, on, you know, doing really good work. And when I don't do that, it's like a really big hit to the ego. I want to treat myself like a friend. Like if I have a bad day where I'm just really not feeling it and I don't do the work or like I don't work to the standard that I wish I could have, but I wasn't feeling it internally, I don't want to berate myself for it. I don't want to be like, oh man, you're a douche for doing it. You're an idiot. Like, oh, come on, you could have done this. You could have done that. I don't want to do that. I just want to be, you know, really kind and gentle to myself. And that's obviously going to take a lot of time to learn. But yeah, I'm just gonna stop being harsh because it's not how I would treat a really good friend of mine. So I'm not sure why I want to treat myself like that either. Of course, there's certain times, you know, where harshness is needed. Like, you know, you end up binge watching a TV show for like 7-14 days straight, and then you want to binge another one. Like, it's just not like, come on, man. Like there's a certain point where you need to draw a line and then you kind of need a bit of a kick on the bum. But like, that's it. Like within reason, I'd have to be harsh on myself, but for the most part, I'm not going to be. The fourth habit that I want to give up is checking my phone first thing in the morning. Now, I've made a previous video about this, about how it's so bad. Like in the morning, right, when you're waking, like your brain is in delta wave. So it's really, really, really slow and really, really steady. When you check your phone, it's like you're going straight from delta, you're skipping, I think it's alpha and like gamma, and you're going straight to like beta brain waves, which is like really highly active. And that's like shocking your system. It's shocking your body. Like you're going straight from a calmness to all of a sudden like hyperactive. And that's not a healthy transition. And I'm doing that almost every morning. Like I've made a video about it, and I've done it really well for a good few months where I didn't check my phone first thing in the morning. And then all of a sudden, you know, things changed, like the world's changing, go in and out of like lockdowns and all that. And you're like, you know what, screw it. And I just picked up my phone first thing in the morning, and I've just been doing that as a habit, and it's been really unhealthy. So I really want to go back to not checking my phone first thing in the morning and making sure that I have a really nice, slow and healthy start to the day. And the last thing that I want to make sure that I get rid of in 2022 is my attachment to money, or rather like my extreme attachment to money. Like I feel like over the past 2 years, because I've lost so much work, I just felt like, you know, I've been in this really strong scarcity mindset where I'm second guessing every single purchase decision that I'm making. I'm even second guessing whether or not I should donate. Like it's like, these are things that, you know, like rightly so, you know, I've like lost a lot of work and therefore lost a lot of money. And so it's a matter of like, you know, what's like, not life or death, but like in my head, it's like almost survival. And I feel like in 2022, I don't want to take that mindset, because, you know, as you think, so you become. If you feel like, you know, you don't have enough, you're always going to feel like you don't have enough, and you're never going to feel like you ever really have enough, and then not getting enough from the world. Whereas if you have come with this mindset of like, you know, I've got heaps, like I've got plenty, I have enough, then the world's going to give you more than you need. And I truly believe that that's how, you know, that's how the universe works. And I want to take that mindset into 2022. And more so, it's because, you know, if I want to pay for something, I don't want to be like, oh, I don't want to, you know, like I should have used that money elsewhere. Like if I want to shout and made a coffee or like lunch, like I don't want to be like, oh man, crap, I wish I didn't get them. Like I shouldn't shout them for that. Like I don't have those thoughts. And of course, you know, that's going to take time and like to transition into that abundance mindset, but it's definitely something that I really want to adopt in 2022. Let me know of a few things that you want to give up in the comment section below in 2022, and you and I can hold each other accountable to this. Let's make 2022 a really, really good year for us. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you like it and you subscribe to the channel. I will definitely see you in the next one. Catch you later. Bye.